Hello folks, in today's video we will make one color flipper like this. So here we can put any color, and when we click on generate color it will change the background color. We can also click on the surprise me button to generate any random color. We will build this using HTML, CSS and JS. So let's get right into it. So I have opened VS Code and I have changed the title to color flipper. I have also linked the style.css and the script.js file with it. Now I will first write one class called container. Now I will write the heading, and that is color flipper. Now I will add one input section where we will add our colors. I will give the ID as, let's say, color input, and I will also give one placeholder, enter color code. It's looking fine. Now I will add one button container class, and here I will add two buttons. Let's name the class as btn. The first button will be named generate color, and the second button will be named, let's say, surprise me. So when we click on this button, a random color will generate. Let's give the ID for the first button as generate color, and for the second button let's give the ID as random color. So that's all the HTML we need here. Now let's add some styles. In the body, first let's change the font family to Arial Helvetica. That's what I always do. And let's give one background color, let's say light yellow. We will revisit this later. Now in the container, I will do display flex. And I'll change the flex direction to column, and I will then do align items center. So everything is centered horizontally. Now let's add some styles to our buttons. First, in the button container class, I will add display flex. So we get our buttons in the horizontal direction. Now in the individual buttons, I will add border as 2 pixels solid black. I will add some margin, let's say 5 pixels, and padding also to be 5 pixels. Let's change the background color to be light coral, and let's add some border radius to be, let's say, 10 pixels. Now let's change the styles of the input tag also. Let's keep it above the button container. So first of all, I'll add the border to be 2 pixels solid black. I will give the height to be, let's say, 25 pixels, and the width to be, let's say, 200 pixels. I will add some margin, let's say 5 pixel again, and let's also increase the font size. Let's give medium. Yeah, now it looks good. Now let's add some JavaScript. So first of all, we will identify the DOM sections. So let's start with the input document get element by ID, and if I remember correctly, the ID was color input. Then we have generate color, and that is document get element by ID, and the ID was generate color. Next we have the surprise me button. Let's name it as random color, and we have document get element by ID, and this is random color. Now we have to understand how can we change the background color using JavaScript. So we can simply do document dot body dot style dot background color equals to, let's say, light blue, and we can see the background color has been changed. Now this change should be done when we click on the generate color button. So let's add the code for that. So we will simply write generate color dot add event listener, and the event is click, and we will write this function doc generate color. We will simply put this code over here. So now if we click on generate color, do we see the color changing? No, that is because one comma is missing here. Now if we click on generate color, we can see that the color is being changed. Now instead of hard coding the color, let's change the color by user input, and doing that is actually very simple. We will simply have to write input color dot value over here, and now if we write red and click on generate color, we can see that the background has changed. Now this red is not disappearing from this input bar, and to do that we can simply do input color dot value equals to an empty string. So now if we write, let's say, blue and generate color, we can see that the blue is disappearing. So we have understood how to change the background color by the click of a button. Now the real question is how to randomize this color. When we click on the surprise me button, the color generated should be random, and to do that we have to first understand what are the different ways we can give color in CSS. So we are back to our style.css file, and we have given here light yellow. Now in place of light yellow, I can also add the color in something like this. So this is called an hexadecimal system, and we can see one grayish color over here. So this is another way we can give color in CSS. Now there are two more ways, and another way is, this is called the RGB. So in this RGB format, there will be three values, one for red, one for green, and one for blue, in between values of 0 and 360. And depending on the respective values of red, green, and blue, we will generate our color. So let's say 200, 150, and 100. And if we save, we can see one dark yellowish color. Now we can make it RGBA, and this A stands for the alpha value, which measures the transparency of the color. This A value can be in between 0 and 1. So let's add it as 0.1. And we can see that the background color is close to white. We can make it 0.5, and it got a little bit color. And now let's make it 0.9, and it is close to the dark yellowish color. And now the last way to add color we will discuss today is HSL. And this HSL stands for hue, saturation, and lightness. This hue value is actually the value of the color, which stands for 0 to 360. And this saturation is how much color do we have, which is in between 0 and 100%. And lastly, this lightness value, as it names, stands for how light or dark the color is. Let's give it as 50%. Now we have one yellow color, red color over here. Now if we make it 120, the color is changed to green. And if we make it 240, the color will be changed to blue. And if we make it 360, the color will be changed to red again. And this is the range in between these values are traveling. Now we can also make it to HSLA, and A stands once again for the alpha value. And here the alpha value can also be in between 0 and 1. If we make it 0.1, it will be a very light pink color. If we make it 0.5, it is one solid pink color. And if we make it, let's say, 0.9, it is very close to red. Now when we are randomizing the colors in the JS, we will use this HSLA format, where we can randomize all these four values, and the generated color will be a random color. Now let me copy this color, change this back to light yellow, and paste this color in JS as a comment only for reference. Now I will write one function, and this will be named generate random color. This function will have no arguments, and this function will make four random values, and that is hue, then we have saturation, then we have, let's say, lightness, and lastly we have alpha value. Now to randomize a value in between 0 and 360, we can simply write math.random into 360. Math.random generates a value in between 0 and 1 which is random, and if we multiply it by 360, we get the range up to 360. And for saturation, this value will be in between 0 and 100. For lightness, it will be in between 0 and 100 again. And for alpha value, this will be only between 0 and 1. Now I will make the color, and the color should be in this syntax. So I will write backtick HSLA first bracket, and then here I will give the variable hue. Similarly, saturation, and here we must add the percentage, and then we have the lightness. We also have the percentage here, and lastly, we have the alpha value, and we also have the closing braces. Now we can simply return this color. Now we can remove this HSLA. Now we have to add another event listener for random color, and the event is click. Let's give the comma this time, and we will simply write that document dot body dot style dot background color equals to whatever color we got, and that color we will get by invoking this function random color, and we will get some color over here. And now our job is to do input color dot value equals to an empty string, so that we don't get the HSLA format there. Now if we click on the surprise me button, we can see that random colors are getting generated. Now in case you have already noticed, there is a minor bug in this app, and that is, if we change the color for some time and we have no inputs over here and we click on generate color, this color is getting changed to light yellow by default. Now we don't want this kind of behavior. When we have no input, the color should not be changed to anything. So let's say we have light green, and if we click on generate color, it should remain light green. It should not be changed to light yellow. And doing that is actually very simple. Only thing we have to write is that if input color dot value is not equal to an empty string, only then change the color to whatever color you get. Otherwise, do nothing. Now let's change the color for some time, and now when we click on generate color, we can see that the background color remains same. So that's it for this video. We have made our color flipper. I will add one GitHub repo link of this project in the description below, and also in the pinned comment, so that you can grab the code from there. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.